I found her.
What is this chest doing in the middle of my living room? Hey,
anybody?
Well, I did bring back some anti-magic gloves from my last trip. They're in the safe now, but who wrote this note? How did he find me? And how does he know that I have the gloves?
What was that? What is happening in here?
Well, just calm down. I need to find someone.
Hello, Susan. My name's Finnyar Stolbern, and even though I'm the captain, not me, not this boat, and definitely not the octopus are real. My body is in deep magical slumber in the Lost Lands, while my mind is doomed to wander between the worlds. My travels are random, chaotic, and produce horrific natural disasters everywhere I go. Someday, I just might cause the destruction of every world I've been to, including yours. Which is why I need your help. Set the compass of the worlds to the Lost Lands. Go there, find my body, and wake me up from my eternal slumber. There's no time to waste. I might jump again any moment now. Please, hurry! the compass into the water! Susan, try to find my wife, would you? She should be...
Where am I?
Well, I guess this qualifies as someone. Maybe he owns this place. I have to talk to him.
You're awake! Welcome to the Mist Coast, the very westernmost province of the Lost Lands. I'm Corko, by the way. The storm was raging a few days ago, the morning you arrived here, and I'm fixing a ferry now. I found you in the river. You surely swallowed a lot of water. Tell me, how did you end up here anyway? What? From the other world? How could it be? Okay, then. What are you looking for here anyway? A captain by the name of Finjur Stolbern? Never heard of him. But look, there is a town on the opposite riverbank called Bay of Sorrows. Sailors and their families used to live there. But if you want to get there, you have to help me fix the ferry first. No, no. An ordinary knife will not cut the bamboo. That is the Bay of Sorrows, the sailor's town. I have to fix the ferry if I want to go there. I still need a couple of nails to fix. Let's make the fairy floor together. Splendid! You can go to Bay of Sorrows now and search for your captain. Why are you in such a hurry anyway? What's that? Our worlds are in danger. Well, I've heard a story of a ghostly ship and its captain, and a giant octopus that show up here and there, but I've always thought it was just a story. So it was true after all. Well, Susan, I'm not the hero type, but if you need anything of me, do not hesitate to ask. I'll be in the burrow. Good luck.
Hey, you! Over there! Help me out! I'm here, and thank you for answering my call! I see you're not from around here. Listen, help... I don't think the hammer is strong enough for such massive shackles.
This ship is just like the one belonging to Captain Stolburn. I have to find my way inside.
Listen, I'm so cold. I can't even move. I need to warm myself first. Somehow. Well, thank you. Wow, this is good. I've been sitting here in the cellar for days now. Can you imagine? The Earl's guardsmen punished me and locked me up in this cellar. Anyway, let me introduce myself. I'm Jep, and I'm in your debt. Tell me, what can I do for you? What's that? Do I know Captain Finuar Stahlburn? Sure I do. I was with his crew on the Grey Flounder a few years back. And the house where I was locked in the cellar is the captain's house. I've been keeping an eye on his house since Finuar has been gone. So, you're after his body? Well, I know where it is. Let me show you. It's not far away, just a bit further down the street. This is a cask of rum. It's sturdy and I can't break it. Darn it all! And naturally, the hand wheel is missing. This is a secret passage to Captain Stahlburn's house. Unfortunately, I don't have a key, and I have no idea where it might be. Hey, Susan! I'm here! On the... That is a Pangonian island. And that is Captain Finuar Stullburn. A few years ago, we came home in this ship from a journey and agreed to meet in half a year. When the time came, everyone was here but Captain Stullburn. After a few days of waiting, one of the sailors noticed something when he viewed Pangonian Island through his looking glass. It was one of those energy capsules with the body of our captain inside. We've tried to get there with our ship, but every time we've gotten lost in the magic mist. You should start at his house if you want to get to the truth behind all this. There's a hidden passage to the house in the cellar, but you'd need a key. Captain's cabin is behind this door. He probably took the key with him. Looks like someone already had a look around. I think Captain went to the Earl's castle to get his wife. I hope you're not going after him. Oh, no, are you sure? Well, all right. It's up to you. In the meantime,
I'll search for the rest of the crew. Be careful and stick to the shadows, please. Here, take this drawing. I got it from my granddad, a berserker warrior. It could prove useful.
Okay, well, now I have to replace all the broken steps with new ones to find out what's inside that hatch.
It's a god-forsaken place. You'll be lost. Don't go.
I have you now.
Well, well, well. Look who we have here. Tell me, little bird, aren't you afraid to get so close to my cage? Do you even know who I am?
I'm Obien, the Earl of the Mist Coast. Now, talk. What were you after in my castle? Speak now. Silence?
Goodness, we have another spy. This one is some old rag.
What's going on today? An open house? Search her. Strip her of everything she has and bring it to the throne room. As for her, throw her in the dungeon. I'll deal with her myself later. Now let's see who else we have here.
Let's go, girlie. Sit here.
Oh. Don't worry. We'll be back soon.
Who's singing? Hey, who's there? Right, I need to get out of here. Luckily, I managed to hide the lockpick in my socks, unnoticed by the guards.
You're the first person I've seen for years. I mean, the first living person. The Earl is keeping me here. You're dressed so strangely. What? From another world? But how could it be? You say you're looking for Finnur Stolbjörn. That's my husband. I'm Nitiel Stolbjörn. But you're too late, I'm afraid. The Earl Obion killed him when he was trying to set me free from this castle. I know this for sure because I saw his body. What are you talking about? What do you mean he's alive? Magic slumber? I can't believe it. But if what you say is true and you've seen the spirit of my husband, and he helped you to get to the Lost Lands, we have to save him. Look, I want to help you, but we need to open this cage first. Can it be true? I can finally escape! We must get to that ruined castle. There's a portal which will take us to Pagonian Island. Here, but there used to be a portal instead of a giant column. That's strange. Oh, here's the portal. Now we need to activate it somehow.
I think someone is coming.
Oh no, the guards found us!
My dear Susan, I'm so glad and mortified to see you in front of me. A friend of mine, the Beaverling Corco, sent a pigeon to me with the news. I know all about you and what you're after. My trailblazer skills helped me to get to Obeon's castle. Then I deliberately surrendered myself to the guards in order to get inside and see where they're holding you. The Earl let it slip that you were in the dungeons. I've gotten rid of the guards with my magic, but Obeon has fled. As for me, I've continued my journey. So, you're after Finyar Stolburn's body, are you? Yes, I've heard the story of his death and afterlife wanderings, but—
My husband isn't dead. I've thought so myself. Instead, he's in a deep magic slumber somewhere on Pangonian Island. And while he's wandering between the worlds, his every jump produces horrific natural disasters.
Well then, our worlds are in danger again. We have no time to lose. The key to the portal might be anywhere. Maybe in the necropolis, maybe in the castle. The dungeon door is locked no more. We can go back to the castle and search it. While the Earl is gone, scared off by my magic tricks. Speaking of which, he dropped this key when he was fleeing. Don't bother. They're just sleeping. I had to do it, or they'd lock me up. Wait. Another guard is here. If he sounds the alarm, all the guards from the castle will rush to this place. We must find a way to neutralize him without anyone noticing.
Maran! And whoever you are, welcome! Welcome! I'm so glad everything's well with you. Susan, dear, the day I fished you out of the river was the day I contacted Marin. I thought I had found someone who resembled Susan the War Maiden herself. Marin appeared before my burrow not long after. I told him everything. About the captain and that horrible, horrible destruction of everything. And off he went. And so he found you. And I'm so happy. So, to what do I owe the pleasure? What now? Berserker's sleeping darts. Well, it's not my specialty exactly, but my tools are at your disposal. Look for them in the barn. Who knows, maybe something will be of use. Here's the key.
Looks like Jeff didn't deceive me. His weapon is working.
Whoa, we made it! We're on the island!
Look, the crypt is just up ahead. Let's move faster. There! Look! That's Finner! My love, I'm here! We'll rescue you soon!
Looks like the home of some local villagers. They may lend us a helping hand. Let's go and ask. Be careful, Susan. I wouldn't... Ah, well, all right.
It's fine. The bridge is sturdy. Follow me.
Right? No? What? Well, I'm not gonna help you. I don't trust anyone these days. But if you help me with a thing or two, then who knows? Listen, I have a rodent invasion going on in my garden. Catch them all if you can. Fill the holes with water and they'll come out. You'll need a hose. And I think I left mine somewhere on the cliff. I think there's some thistle growing there now. Also, you must have seen my husband's grave on your way here. He was so fond of his helmet when he was alive. When he learned that the Earl's warriors were seizing all the valuables, he hid it somewhere in the necropolis. Find that helmet and place it on his grave to honor his memory. Do as I ask, then we'll talk. I'm sorry to behave that way, but I had to be sure you meant no harm. So, yes, where was I? I'm Shelisa. Are you interested in the magic crypt? It appeared on the cliff a couple of years ago, all of a sudden. I remember it even now. Such a mess. All those mages, earls, guardsmen, slaves, and her. A witch from the castle. Albion's archmage. She was the one who built that energy barrier. And then they put a crystal cube holding a male body inside the crypt. The witch died not long after and was buried somewhere in the necropolis. I suggest you look for a grave to find the answers you seek. Oh my, why are we talking here at the door? Come inside, please.
looks like the witch's crypt. And there's the sarcophagus. Let's examine everything thoroughly. Any detail might turn out to be crucial.
Talking to Fahira directly would be much better, but...
Maron, looks like your wish may come true. We'll attempt to summon Fahira's ghost. Wow, looks like this wall is barely holding the river as it is.
Mama, what's this? I'm scared.
Psst. These are the restless souls of the necropolis we summoned.
Time to visit Bahira's crypt. I hope our plan worked.
Mortals, oh, what a long time it's been since someone talked to me. I am Fahira. I did a lot of things I later regretted when I was alive, but that's not why I was doomed to eternal suffering. I've put someone into a magic slumber. Someone who was innocent. I used dark spells to do it, and the gods cursed me with eternal suffering between the worlds of the living and the dead. You're my last chance to fix all this. There's a door in the Earl's castle, a door which leads to my lab. Only the touch of my hand could open it when I was, well, alive. Use my hand to open the door. You'll find all you need to know about the magic crypt and how to place a man into magic slumber, as well as how to lift the curse. But there's one thing. One of you will need to be sacrificed. I thank you.
Careful not to run into him on the way.
Help me! Go without me. I won't go anywhere. We'll figure out how to get me out later on. Now it's more important to wake up Finnar.
Thank you.
Hmm? A ship is coming. Oh no! It's the Earl's ship! I have no idea where Obi-Wan was all this time, but my gut tells me he knew about our plan all along. How else can you explain him showing up here on the battleship? What should we do now? Wait, I have an idea. We have to get the cube with the captain's body without breaking it, right? Do you remember why the wall was built on this island? Let me tell you, it was built in order to divide the river, which used to flow exactly where the magic crypt was. So, what if we destroy the wall? The river will flow right through the center and fill up the crypt, and the cube will float up. Ha! And that's where the Earl's cannons will help us. We'll need to sneak onto his ship and fire them right at the wall.
Oh no, Nitiel is gone. But how and where? All this is very strange. I can hear some voices coming from the cap.
Guards, go to the captain. Keep your eyes on the cliff. You spot anyone, fire at them with Embrace cannon. I'm going to have a rest.
What happened to that damn door? Let's break it down!
Thank you.
It worked. Hurry to the cliff. We must get the captain from the cube. Obi-Wan has escaped his cabin! Oh no! He has Nakiel! He's going to kill her! Susan, Obi-Wan has captured Nakiel, and he's going to kill her! I think he got her from the trap in the lab, and he knows everything now.
Oh no! My poor Nakiel! We have to do something! My body! Why is it acting like this? I can't control it.
It's because you've spent a couple of years in the state of weightlessness. You have to get your strength back. Susan, I want to brew a special potion so our captain can regain his strength. But I am missing one ingredient, the body of a shellfish. There are usually some at the reefs. You can ask Shalisa for her fishing net. I think it might come in handy.
Wait. I know for a fact that somewhere underneath Obi-Wan's castle is a secret passage with a sword named Smasher hidden inside. Bring it to me. That and some clothes from my house, please. Here's a key. You'll need it. And meanwhile, we'll think of how to get to the Earl and save my Nitiel. Many thanks, Susan. I knew I could count on you. My strength is coming back to me, but I need more time. Listen to what Marin and I came up with. Do you know about the old lighthouse? The one at the necropolis? Well, Magic Guild members used to keep it lit using a sky dome miniature generated somewhere in the old lecture hall. Marin says there's a portal there. You should try to light it and point the beam at Obion's ship. He'll follow the light, only to meet his doom. Meanwhile, Marin and I will get moving as soon as the potion starts working. Hopefully, we'll get to the ship and save the TL before you switch on the lighthouse.
My fishing net? It's the only one I have. Well, my husband was a good fisherman, but I'm not really using it nowadays. I feed myself with things I grow in the garden now. All right, I'll give it to you, but on one condition. I've been planning to visit my husband's grave for a long time now. His tombstone is all covered with moss. Take this brush and clean it, would you? Then I'll give you the net. Thanks for everything. I'll spare no expense for such enormous help.
Oh, thank you. Just what I need. Hey, Susan, while you were away, I checked one of my caches, and here's what I found. Take it. It may come.
I'm here, Captain!
Let's run, my love, while the guards are blind.
You let them get away, you morons!
Together at last.
Thank you, Susan. Here, take this medallion as a token of our gratitude.
Here's an idea. Let's go to Corco, everyone. He has this splendid homemade liquor. Or so I was told.